Hello friends, you are welcome on my YouTube channel. Today we are going to the new lesson. The name of our new lesson is Profit and Loss. The price at which an object is purchased is called its cost price. And this cost price we write in CP. The price at which an object is sold is called its selling price. We call it selling price, and selling price is written in SP. If the selling price of an object is greater than its cost price, then there is a profit in the transaction. And if the cost price of an object is greater than its selling price, then there is loss in the transaction. To find profit and loss, or profit percent, loss percent, or selling price or cost price, there are some formulas, let's see, which are there. First, profit. To find out profit, subtract cost price from selling price, then we will get our profit. Next, profit percent. To find out profit percent, write down profit over cost price and multiply it by 100. We can get profit in percent. Next, to find a loss. When we get loss, if our cost price is greater than selling price, then we should subtract selling price from cost price, then we can get our loss. If we have to find loss percent, then write down loss over cost price and multiply it by 100. Keep in mind, always while calculating profit percent or loss percent, always calculate on cost price, because whatever profit or loss we are gaining, it is on cost price only. Selling price. If it is asked in question to find out selling price, then write down 100 plus gain percent over 100, multiply this by cost price. If again it is asked selling price and loss is given in the question, then write down 100 minus loss percent over 100, multiply it by cost price. And if cost price is asked in the question to find, then write down 100 over 100 plus gain percent into selling price. And if there is loss in the transaction and it is asked first to find out cost price, then write down 100 over 100 minus loss percent into selling price. How we have to use this formula in exercise or in questions? Let's see one exercise. Profit and loss first exercise. You can see the question on the top of the screen. First question is that a hawker bought chikus at rupees 32 per dozen and sold them at rupees 40 per dozen. Find his profit percent. What information is given in this question? Cost price of chikus is rupees 32 per dozen, and he sold that chiku. So the selling price of 40 rupees per dozen, and profit percent we have to find in this question. To find profit percent, first find out the profit. What is formula of profit? Profit equals selling price minus cost price. In this question, selling price is 40 rupees and cost price is 30 rupees. So 8 rupees profit is there in this transaction. Now we can find profit percent. What is formula of profit percent? Profit percent equals profit over cost price into 100. What is our profit? Profit is 8 rupees. Our cost price is 32 rupees into 100. 8 1 the 8, 8 4 the 32, 1 by 4 into 100, 4 1 the 4, 4 25 the 100, What remains 1 into 25? So in this transaction, there is 25% profit. I hope all of you understand this question. See, cost price is 32 rupees, selling price is 40 rupees. To find profit percent, we found first profit. What is profit? Selling price minus cost price. Selling price is 40 rupees and cost price is 32 rupees. 40 minus 32 is 8. Profit percent equals profit by selling cost price into 100. Our profit is 8 rupees and cost price was 32. So 8 over 32 into 100, 1 by 4 into 100, and at last we got 25. So 25% profit is there in this transaction. Second question. A boy sold his old book for rupees 64. He sold old books. Then it is selling price of book. What is selling price of book? 64 rupees at 20% loss. And in this transaction, he gained loss of 20%. What was the cost price of the book? In this question, it is asked to find cost price of the question. What is formula of cost price? Cost price equals 100 over 100 minus loss percent into selling price. This is formula of finding cost price. If loss is given and if percentage is given, then add here profit percent. So put values 100 over 100 minus 20 into selling price is 64. 100 over 100 minus 20 equals 80 into 64. This zero is cancelled. 8 1 the 8 and 8 the 64. What remains? This side 8 and this side 8. 10 into 8 equals 80 rupees. So we can say that the cost price of that book is 80 rupees. How we found this answer? First, pay attention. Selling price is given and loss is given in the question. The formula of cost price is 100 over 100 minus loss percent into selling price. 100 over 100 minus 20% loss is given, that's why we subtracted it from 100 into 64. 100 over 80 into 64, this 0 we cancel. 8 1 the 8, 8 the 64. What remain? 10 into 8, 10 8 the 80. So we can say that 80 rupees is cost price of that book. Next question. A person bought pencils at rupees per dozen. He bought, means it is cost price. Cost price of pencil is rupees per dozen. And sold them at rupees per two pencils. He bought the pencils by dozen and he sold single pencil. And selling price of that pencil, one pencil he sold for 2 rupees. Then how much cost of 12 pencils? 1 dozen means 12. So 12 into 2, it is 24. So our selling price is 24 rupees. Find the profit percent. In this transaction, they are asking us to find profit percent. Just now we saw that to find profit percent, first we should find the profit. What is profit in this transaction? Selling price minus cost price. What is selling price of 1 dozen pencil? It is 24. And the cost price of pencil is 20. So in this transaction, 4 rupees profit is there. Now we can find profit percent. To find profit percent, profit percent equals profit over cost price into 100. What is profit in this transaction? 4 rupees profit. Our cost price is 20 rupees cost price. So 4 over 20 into 100. 21 are 20, 25 are 100. 4 into 5 equals 20. 20% profit was there in this transaction. I hope you are understanding these questions. You can also try to solve these questions. If you have any problem or any doubt, you can ask me in comment box. Next question. By selling an article for ₹750, a person makes 20% profit. The cost price of the article is, in this question, cost price is asked, and what information is given? First, selling price of an article is given. So we can say that SP 750 rupees. Next, profit percent given. ₹20 profit was there in this transaction, and we have to find cost price in this question. So what is the formula of cost price? Cost price equals 100 over 100 plus profit percent into selling price. So 100 over 100 plus 20% profit was there. So add 20 it, and selling price is 750. 120 into 750. This zero cancel. 12 ones are 12. 12 six are 72. 3 and 0 13. 12 ones are 12. 12 twos are 24. Now 6 remain. 6 is not divisible by 12 because 6 is smaller to 12. That's why you hear decimal and it becomes 60 now. So 12 ones are 12. 12 fives are 60. What remain? Here 10 into 62.5. If you multiply these, then we can get 625. So we can say that the cost price of that shirt was 625. Next question. You can see question on the top of the screen. A man purchased 120 mangoes at ₹4 per mango. He purchased 120 mangoes and he purchased one mango for ₹4. Total mangoes he purchased 120, multiply this by 4, so we can get that 12 fours are 48,400. Cost price is 480 rupees. It is our cost price. 20 mangoes were eaten. He sold rest of mangoes at the rate of ₹48 for 10. Out of 120 mangoes, 20 mangoes were eaten. So only 100 mangoes remain. And these 100 mangoes he sold ₹48 for 10 mangoes. So we can say that he sell one mango for ₹4.8. He had total 100 mangoes. So multiply this number by 4, 4.8 by 100 rupees 4.8 into 100 so it become rupees 480 what it is saying what is his gain or loss see if we study this question he bought 120 mangoes one mango for 4 rupees then 120 mangoes cost price is 480 our cost price is 480 but out of 120 mangoes 20 mango were rotten so how many mangoes were remain 100 so he can sell only 100 mangoes not 120 so we multiply he sold 48 rupees 10 mangoes he can say that he sell one mango for 4.8 rupees but he has 100 mangoes so what is the cost selling price of 100 mangoes we multiply this 4.8 by 100 so our selling price is 480 in this transaction our cost price and selling price both are same so we can say that there is no gain or no loss in this transaction next question when a shirt was sold for rupees 2500 selling price of shirt 2500 rupees there was 25% profit profit percent is given profit what was the cost price of the shirt we have to find out cost price of the shirt what is formula of cost price 100 over 100 plus profit percent into selling price 100 over 100 plus our profit percent is 25 given into selling price is 2500 is given so 100 over 125 into 2500 125 and this 0 0 what remain here 100 and this side 20 100 into 20 equals 2000 so we can say that the cost price of shirt was 2000 rupees how you calculate it we wrote the formula of selling cost price the formula of cost price is 100 over 100 plus profit percent into selling price we put the given values profit percent was 25% and the selling price was 2500 100 plus 25 equals 125 we wrote 100 over 125 and multiply this fraction by cost selling price 125 was 125 125 to the 250 this 0 0 120 remain 100 into 20 equals 2000 this question was asked in 2013 nowadays exam next question a person bought some oranges at the rate of rupees 10 for 2 cost price is rupees 10 for 2 oranges so what is the cost price of one orange we can say that rupees 5 is the cost price of one orange he sold them at the rate of rupees 18 for 3 selling price is given rupees 18 for 3 so we can say that rupees 6 for one orange in this transaction his profit was profit is first in this transaction
So what is our cost price? First find out profit. Profit equals selling price minus cost price. What is our selling price? 6 rupees and cost price is 5 rupees. It is 1 rupees. And if we have to find its profit percent, the formula of profit percent is profit over cost price into 100. Our profit was 1 rupees and cost price was 5 rupees into 100. 5 is the 5, 5 is the 10, 5 0 is 0. 1 into 20 equals 20% profit was there in this transaction. I hope you understand all these exercises. If you like this video, share to other students who are preparing for Navoday examination and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.